chicken in a bag.
I'm in my bag, chicken in a bag.
We're on the way up a mountain right now because we're going to go.
Oh, straight.
I would turn around, but maybe you can see. Fuck, you can't. Hold on.
Yeah, you can't flip the camera.
I know, bro. You can't. And I don't want people to know where I live either. Because, like,
I swear, I noticed people like in their comments were from our gym too, bro. They'll be like, oh, he lives in the Bay Area. Not that I live there, but
I notice that they say that, and I'm like, bro.
First of all, it's weird. It's because you shouldn't be giving away people's location like that. It's just weird. Like, that's weird how I accept it.
Usually I blend this shit and I drink it, but okay. I created that. Chicken in a bag.
And I don't even follow people on TikTok like that just because, like, I don't find their shit that entertaining.
Yeah.
And it's like, I genuinely have to fuck with you, or I have to like your stuff a lot. And I don't want to see it continuously, that's the thing. And there's so much repeated content on TikTok that's just like people talking about the same just repeated joke, like talking about calves. When you see my gym crush, like, bro, we don't care about that. We want to care about who you are, what you like to, like, what you do on the daily. Like, you can repeat the same old, like, lifting content, or like, what you, like, the, even the public interviews. Like, you just have to put your own spin on it. Like, a way that attracts audience that who you are. Take it right here, my fault.
Right here.
You have to attract your audience of, based on who you are, you know.
Right, man, chicken everywhere.
He's getting gas, but what I was saying was that, like, you could post the same old regurgitated shit that people put out, like, what you eat in a day, what your training split is, what you like, you know? But it's like, do you really want to be that one-dimensional? You know, it's like, is that the kind of person that you want to show that you are to your audience that fucks with you for you? Or would you rather show how you are as a person and what depth you have to your personality to attract and keep the audience that fucks with you? And it's not even that, like, I'm trying to win you guys over. It's just that I'd like to genuinely be me in front of people now in my relationships because of how I previously
used to be.
We're talking about shit. No, you could be involved in.
Really?
Not shit.
It was 3x4 before, but like now I switched to 16x9. So now it's like a YouTube video and I could be playing music in the background. I just don't want this copyrighted, so I'll probably cut right here. Like literally in clouds right now, like inside them, and like the camera isn't picking it up.
When it's cold outside.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I come here and she gets hella cold, hella easy. So she's like, it's like 60, like maybe 40 degrees right now, 50. But it'd be hella cold, bro. Like pulled over side of the road. Cars and it comes here, little ass dick, bro. Such a little smeet ass up. Bro, you're pissing on your balls, small little dick ass dude. No, I'm saying people are sunning their balls, like, for real. Like, they'll put their balls up. They'll put their balls up and, like, sun them. Because, like...
And sun them as in tan.
Like, legs. Put your legs, like... Toot that ass up and like fucking sun up, because they think that it's like the best way to boost your tan. Well, because they don't get as much sunlight as you think they do. It's kind of like people saying like you want to touch the floor with your bare feet because your feet don't touch the floor as often as they should. Fries were not it, bro. They were hella dry. He wants to go get fried chicken, bro, but probably has like 2 grams of protein per fucking. Dave's hot chicken was good, bro. My ex-girlfriend, and like whenever I went, bro, I would like fucking bust in my pants. No, pause. And she'd be like, "Damien, I think I showed you that video." Or like I'm eating it, and she would just be. Yeah, bro. She just cold as shit. Gosh. Bless you. Ugly ass sneeze. I hate annoying ass sneezes, bro. That one kid, remember that one Asian kid, Austin? I don't think you remember, bro. He went to my middle school. Austin. He had this sneeze, obnoxious ass sneezes. I hate him, bro. Like he sneezed and he would like be dumbass loud and I would press him. I'd be like, bro, stop sneezing like that. That's like annoying. And he just was like, bro, I can't control it. Little nerd ass virgin voice, bro.
Can't control it.
And he sneezes like 6 times in a row and it's just loud. I'm like, bro, shut up.
So there's contact lens that capture vision.
Or like glasses that you could wear all the time, but then you'd have to be wearing glasses like the entirety of your fucking.
That's what I'm saying. Should I text?
And say what?
I don't know. Send her fucking a jimpy.
Just send her what you're doing right now.
Yeah, that too.
Be like, thought of you. I'd be doing it. I'd be sending girls pictures, bro, and like of what I'm doing. I'm just like, I thought of you. Like that's free game, guys. Free game. But it's like you want to be genuine with like women, bro. Like you want to, if you're genuinely thinking of them, like the thing that reminded you, you're gonna send it to them. And like, it doesn't really matter if they like you. You could only, if a girl really likes you, like you could only really mess up. Like you could, and the thing is, you could still say like out of pocket shit, just nothing too out of pocket. But you can say shit like another day something, bro, and I was like, I thought of you, or I sent something, and I was like, oh, this reminds me of you, and then she'll just, it's like something you, it's, I don't know.
No, I don't know.
It's not weak, there's no, like, weak for a girl, bro. I was telling, Ian, my therapist, that, bro, about me thinking that I was used to be weak before for doing shit like that, and then, like, the way, best way I could describe it, bro, is, like, that incel mentality, incel hating women, like, because at a certain extent, that low-key is what it is, bro. You have a resentment towards, like, women and a resentment towards, like, how they treated the nice guy you or, like, the guy that you used to be. So it's, like, you change based off according to your market value because now the guy that you are now girls want to fuck you. Now girls want to chill with you. Now girls want to link up with you. Now they want to give you some pussy because of how you are now. But what you don't know is that your resentment is just building against women because you can't genuinely be the real you. And like we
we all grow up and we hit like a certain point where, oh, like, I'm tired of putting on this facade. I finally want to be me in front of the girl that will finally accept me for me. And we all have like different words of affirmation. Like, my thing that I love hearing from girls, bro, is, no, Damien, I like you for you. Shit like that, bro. That, like, that gets me wet.
Wait, what?
I'm saying, that shit, like, turns me on, bro. Hear your girl say, I like you for you. Like, I love hearing that. I think that's my thing that I love hearing. Like, some people love hearing, I love you. Some people love hearing, you're doing great. Some people love hearing, you're doing everything right. But, like, hell no, this light sucks. But, like,
These ones are white.
But, like, with me, like, I think, like, I like hearing that I'm doing everything correct. Like, you're not doing anything wrong, Damien. Why? Because I like you for you. I like you for the guy that you are.
It's kind of hard to get that, like, out of it. Or, like, oh, it depends who, too, bro. I don't like sharing shit, bro.
Yeah, but that's, like, that's what I'm saying. But, and, like, the women that you... Those are the kind of women that you... That need healing themselves and to go through and put the work in. You can only put the work in, bro. It's like, or you can stay the same person that you forever will be and not grow. Not all, like, change is growth, but for sure people can change. Like, and we learn based off of, like, trial and error. I told him about what you said about how you feel about, right? And she said... I mean, he was like, yeah, he's like, well, basically he's going through the same thing kind of you are with the other chick. And he's like, you need to assess, like, are my actions, what I told you. I was basically regurgitating what the information that he told me to you, bro, that if your morals align with your current actions, then you're okay. It's okay. But he told me something that I didn't think about. He said, you're allowed to have the conversation of, if you feel like, even though you told her that, hey, I feel like I
want to go with the flow.
Yeah, even if you told her that, I want to go with the flow. Yeah. I don't want a relationship. Yeah. But
I didn't tell her that either.
Let's say you did, right?
Okay.
And you still feel like you're using her. Let's say you still feel like you are. Mm-hmm. Then just have the conversation. Hey, I told you I don't want a relationship, I still feel guilty because I feel like I'm using you. I just want to make clear if you think that I'm using you. So, and then I was like, damn, you could. I was like, do you believe you can say shit like that? He's like, you can.
No, yeah, you can, bro.
He's like, you can.
It's just be confident in saying it. Like, bro, like, stop being, like, secretive and shit. I was just being more bold, I guess. Kind of also to, like, get her to be like, oh, okay, Sophie, I'm more, like, talking more now. I should probably, like, so she's comfortable also saying, like, what she feels.
Yeah, you could set a positive example. It's just, like, it's just the reinforcement that people get, bro. It's, like, if you do an action and people respond negatively, then you probably won't want to do that action again because all you're getting is negative reinforcement from it. Like, you fucking get brand new pair of shoes, and every single time you get a brand new pair of shoes, you step in mud. You're like, fuck, I'm not going out with my new shoes ever again. But
who's Ian?
It's a therapist.
Oh.
He was like, I think you guys had a co-identity crisis. And I was like, what do you mean? And he was like, because you were avoidant with everything that, all your actions, you didn't want to talk about how you felt. You just wanted to have, like, he's like, based off the information that I know about your past relationship, he's like, I think you guys just had a co-identity, like, crisis because certain actions, like her yelling at you or her, like, getting really emotional every single time you wanted to talk about something serious, that may have negatively reinforced how you feel about having and expressing those emotions and conversations. So you just constantly avoided them, but constantly avoiding them caused her to have a reaction of, like, resentment towards me. But since she's idolizing me, she puts up with so much bullshit that I'm putting her through, so she can't leave me. It's easy to say that it's somebody else's fault. He's like, and I think it's also easy to say that it's just your fault
because I like
like your butt.
But I can't wife a thotty.
Hey, people change. Do people change though?
And it's like you're rejecting the idea that people fucking change. But it's like, I don't want to wife a thotty. So it's just like, what do you accept in your own life, bro? That's really all it is. Like, what?
That's what I'm saying. Like, it all goes back to, bro, you do whatever the fuck you want. Like, just like do what you feel is right.
Just your own boundaries and like what you would put up with. That's really all it is. Your own boundaries and what you would put up with.
Can we please get somebody to eat? Please.
When is cold? Let's go, bro.